Hello YouTube, welcome to my channel Cecret Point. My name is Milan and in this video session we have to see our first desktop application or Windows-based applications. Okay, so here in the screen you can see that I am using my NetBeans IDE for creating my first application. If you want, you can use your Notepad or Edit Plus or some other IDE if you are having, like Eclipse or NetBeans. But it is a good programming practice if you will start doing coding with your NetBeans IDE. Okay, this is the most advanced tools or advanced IDE which is providing so much features. Okay, so it is, I am recommending this one. If you want to use any other IDE, means you can use that one. Okay, so without not wasting much time, let's start the project. Okay, so for creating a new Java project, we need to select this file menu, then go to this new project, and this prompt will open. Okay, in this prompt you have to select this Java option from the left side bar, and in the right side you have to select this Java application. Okay, and you need to click on next button so that it will open this prompt, and here in the screen you have to give your project name, your project location, that is where you want to keep your project, and finally if you want your main class, means if you want to create the main method also, then you need to select this one, or else you suggest to deselect this one. Okay, now click on finish button. As I have already created one project, so I'm not going to click on finish button. And this is the project what I was created, swing app, and inside this swing app project I'm having one default package. Let's take a package with our name. Okay, so for creating a package you just need to right click on it, go to new and click on this Java package, and now give a package name. I am giving com.googly. okay, this is my website which is going to soon launch, and click on finish button. Now you can see that our package got created, and in order to create a new class inside that package, I need to right click on it, go to new, and then select this Java class. Then you have to give your class name, that is my first application. Okay, this is the class name what I was given, and this is having the package com.googly. its location is what you have selected while creating the project, all those things. Okay, so now click on finish button. It is going to create one class with our name what we have given here. Now wait for some time, it is going to take some time to create the class. Okay, okay, now you can see in this our class got created. Okay, our class name is that my first application. Okay, so within this class I am creating one main method, that is public static void main. This is my main method. Within this class I am going to create one frame. Okay, so we can create a frame in two ways, either by extending the frame class or by creating the object of a frame class. Okay, so and we can create the frame either in the constructor or in the main method or in the any other user defined method. Okay, in the three different area we can create a frame. So here I am going to take the help of a constructor. So take a constructor. Constructor name should be equal with your class name, right? So this is the constructor. Okay, now just above of that constructor take one class object, that is JFrame class object, and within that constructor I'm going to initialize that frame class equal to new JFrame. Okay, now in order to display the frame class we need to use the method called setVisible. This is a method which you have to use to display, to enable the frame visible. Okay, in order to set the frame visible you have to use this setVisible method. By this method your frame is going to be visible on the screen. Okay, now what you have to do is you have to just create one object for your class my first application, then only it is going to call your constructor. Okay, whenever you are going to create any object of your class your constructor is going to execute, right? So for that reason you have to create your class object here. Okay, now our program is ready. Now let's execute this program and see what output we are getting. Here in the screen you can see that I have already imported one class, that is javax.swings.jframe. Okay, this is the jframe is the class which is under javax.swing package that you have to import, or else you will get compile time error. Okay, now in the screen you can see that our frame got created. Okay, as I was not mentioned any of the height width of the frames, that's why it is not visible properly, but it is created. Now unfortunately I closed on swing that frame close button, but it is still running in the background, you can see. So now I have to forcefully shut down it, but what I have to do to terminate it normally is you have to call the set default close operation method, and you have to pass the jframe dot exit on close constant. Okay, then what will happen is whenever I will click on that close button, directly the application or the frame is going to be closed, it is not going to run background. Okay, so wait for some time, it is executing our program and soon it is going to create one frame. Okay, now you can see in the screen that our frame got created. Okay, this is the frame. Here in the screen you can see that this is the frame, but whenever I will click on this close button, it is going to close now. Okay, now you can see that our program also got terminated normally. So this is all about creating a frame and making it visible true. In the upcoming video session we will learn about more functions or methods of swing related to JFrame. Okay, so this is all about this video session. Hope you like. If you do like, then please do subscribe to my channel and keep sharing with your friends. Thanks for watching. Take care.